some of us are probably already angling for lunch. Attention span is probably a bit short. I intend to skip the theoretical part of it, but what I have done for you are two things. I have sent the entire presentation to the organizers, and they will be making sure that you receive them. So for those of you who might be interested in the theoretical part, feel free to you know, request that. Also on my blog, colinsuweke.eu, the presentation has just been posted there a few minutes ago. So it could also be downloaded there. Now, do we have a pointer, or somebody will be changing that for me? Yes, okay then. Good. Now, where am I coming from with this whole story? This story actually began in 2014, when I took a bit of interest in what is happening around the European Commission, specifically the European Parliament. I talked with a number of colleagues in my party in Belgium, and we came to the point that it might be an interesting thing to you know, run for the European Parliament. Of course, a few of us you know, laughed that out. As you know, it's a very long process, starting with primaries. You need to win the primaries first before you effectively become a candidate. And there were hundreds, if not thousands, of us. But then I thought that Europe has become so very important, not only for Europe itself, but for the rest of the world, particularly Africa, that some of us should dare to, you know, raise some issues that our European colleagues don't quite appreciate, or maybe don't understand, or maybe those issues are less of a priority to them than some of us whose initial orientation is Europe. So on that basis, you know, we went for it, and you know, surprisingly, I won the primaries, and then became a candidate for the election to the European Parliament in May, specifically 2014. Now, of course, we knew that the chances were small, but politics is a group sport, at least from my perspective. And so the understanding then was that we were in there to support the key candidates, okay, who were on the top of the list. But then it was an opportunity also to, you know, raise some points and bring them out there and let those points that are of interest to us as people of African origin, let them constitute the debates, you know, that people should be talking about. For example, trade, fair trade between Africa and Europe, issues of migration, and so on and so forth. And so we did it that way. Of course, after the election, I felt that a tool or a platform needs to be created to continue those issues that are of importance to me, but also to the nearly 12,000 people who voted me during the election. That was what gave rise then to organizing for a fairer Europe, which is a blog. Now and again, I scribble one or two things, post them there. I also post the thoughts, you know, third-party thoughts and, you know, policy issues, policy analysis, and so on and so forth. Before then, I had been invited by, you know, Television Continental to, you know, now again, do some you know, policy analysis for them. I wasn't sure it was something I wanted to do, but after the election, I found out, I thought it would be an additional, you know, platform to, you know, bring out those issues of relevance. So yes, I took that on. Now, I was happy when I was invited to this event to talk about the EU Trust Fund for migration from Africa. The reason being that 1.8 billion euros has been made available by the European Commission to use in managing migration from Africa. Four specific countries were named in this trust fund as partners of the fund. That doesn't exclude other African countries, but those were the priority countries. And that was based on analysis of where the largest number of refugees or migrants were coming from. Nigeria is included in that country, Sudan is there, and a number of, you know, a couple of others. Now, what surprised me and my friends and colleagues, both at the European Parliament and at the national level in Belgium, is that we are not aware that any of the key countries named in the trust fund as key partners actually ever did a proposal to the European Commission to have access to this fund. Yet, their citizens, especially the young people, keep dying in the Mediterranean Sea trying to cross over to Europe. So it's a shame.